Hey guys, in this video we're going to cover how to use the Xpand 2 virtual instruments in Pro Tools first. If you haven't checked out the previous tutorials in this series, I recommend watching them, especially the one on how to input MIDI notes. The main virtual instrument that we use in Pro Tools first is called Xpand 2. This is a software synthesizer that can create a bunch of different instrument sounds, and it includes percussion as well. To use Xpand 2, the first thing we need to do is add a virtual instrument. Before we do that though, it's important to understand the difference between a MIDI track and an instrument track in Pro Tools first. Both of these tracks have MIDI on them and can record and edit MIDI through the piano roll. The distinction comes when we consider the output. MIDI tracks only output MIDI, so you won't and can't put an instrument plugin on it. Instrument tracks don't output MIDI, they output audio, similar to the audio tracks we looked at in the previous tutorials. One way we can set this up in Pro Tools first is to add 4 MIDI tracks for every instrument track using Xpand 2. That way we're only running one plugin and we can have 4 different instruments playing. To set this up, add Xpand 2 on the instrument track. Then route the outputs of each of the MIDI tracks to a different Xpand MIDI input. This is done with the output dropdown under the I/O section for the MIDI tracks. Then we need to consider each of the 4 modules in the Xpand plugin to receive the MIDI channel input. To turn on each module, press the power button. This can be used to disable the different modules we're not using, especially if we do layering like we'll see later. Pressing the A, B, C, and D buttons changes the smart knobs to the ones that control that module at the top. We can't really go through all these in this video since they vary based on the different modules we're using. Some cool controls that can really make a difference, especially on the pads, are the attack and release. The pads usually have a swell in volume when they turn on and off, and these controls adjust that. The attack will control how fast it fades in after you hit the note, and the release sets how fast it fades out after you end the MIDI event, so the sound doesn't cut off immediately when the MIDI event ends. You have everything from different instruments like winds and brass to synth sounds and pads that can be used to create an ambient background sound. There's also drum kit sounds you can use, and you can program drum beats on the piano roll, but that's really tricky because the piano roll doesn't display what part of the drum kit you're using. Luckily, if you hit a note when you draw it on the piano roll, you can hear it so you'll know what you're working with. The modules also have individual controls you can use to adjust the mix. They have a volume level to control the balance between them, and there's also a master volume for the entire plugin at the top right corner. The plugins also have a pan knob and 2 send level knobs to control the amount of effects applied down below. The right side of each module has a few more controls to look at. First, let's look at the play tools. This controls how the module responds to MIDI events. The first section on the left is for transposition. The top one tunes the synth up and down in semitones. The one below is for fine tuning. Both of these can be adjusted by clicking and dragging up and down. The high and low key section controls what MIDI inputs that module will actually respond to. By default, they'll respond to the complete range of MIDI notes. Each module can be restricted. For example, you can set one synth to respond to only bass notes and another to respond to higher notes. You'll be able to play those both on the same MIDI track, and Xpand will automatically split them up. Monophonic and polyphonic determines how many notes Xpand will register at once. In monophonic, only one note will play at once, so you can't play any chords, but you can use it for leads. Below that, it gives you the options for which note it will choose if you hit more than one. It can play the first note pressed, last note, or choose based on which note is highest or lowest. In poly mode, the selector decides how many notes it can respond to at once. The last option on the right is the pitch bend range. Next up is the arpeggiator. The first button on the left turns the arpeggiator on and off. The next button is latch. In latch mode, the arpeggiator and note will continue until either a new note is pressed or the arpeggiator is turned off. The mode sets the pattern that the arpeggiator will use around each note. Finally, the rate sets how fast the arpeggiator goes. So 1 is a whole note and 8th is an 8th note. The asterisk represents a dotted note and the T notes are triplets. The last tool we have is to control a modulation wheel. Unfortunately, I won't be able to demonstrate this for this video since I don't have a MIDI controller with this feature, but we can still talk about what it does. The first dropdown is for the mod wheel shape. After that, we have a control for what the mod wheel is controlling, such as pitch, volume, panning, and a few different controls that have various effects depending on the preset you're using. The rate sets the rate of modulation, and the depth sets the amount applied. To the right, we have controls for aftertouch. Aftertouch is basically a MIDI signal of how much you're pressing the key after the initial press, and it can be used to adjust the pitch and other controls as well, with a depth option for the amount. At the bottom of the Xpand 2 plugin, we have some effects that can be applied as sends to all the modules together. The top dropdown selects what kind of effect you'll be using, and there's lots of effects such as reverb, delays, and chorus. They'll all have individual controls, but there's only a few knobs for each, so they're really simple to use. The last thing we can do with this plugin is use it to layer multiple presets instead of using them separately with different MIDI tracks. If we use it on an instrument track or send multiple MIDI tracks to the same MIDI channel for Xpand, then more than one module can use the same MIDI signal. That allows us to create some really cool custom sounds by combining whatever different sounds we want. Thanks for checking out this video on using the Xpand 2 virtual instrument in Pro Tools First. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to check out the rest of the videos in this Pro Tools First series to continue learning the program. You can also like the video, subscribe to the channel, and check out our social media links to stay up to date on all our new content.